the head of my life, the author and the finisher of my faith.
That's it.
He is my beginning, my end. He wrote my story. He made all the edits and the changes and the corrections. And he saw fit, amen, for me to be here today. And I just praise him that I made it. I'm still here. Amen. To God be the glory, giving honor to my pastor,
dear God,
my mentor,
amen,
spiritual father, friend, brother, all of it all wrapped up into one. I just thank God for our pastor, Pastor Grant. We have the best pastor.
Amen.
In the land. Amen. To God.
Amen.
Amen. He humbles himself before God.
Yes, Jesus. Thank you, Pastor.
Allow me to be here today. And just heard the Lord, and I'm just so grateful. I'm honored, Pastor, and I say thank you, amen, to all the ministers on the pulpit, all those that assemble here, family, friends, loved ones, Lottie, Dottie, and everybody. And I always tell you, too, the snakes, I thank you, too.
Amen.
Because it's the snakes that keep the rats away.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. To God be the glory. The Lord says he will set a table before you in the presence of your enemies. Amen. Because he wants them to see how he blessed you.
Yes.
Amen. And we just give God the glory for that. So I thank you. Those that thank you, say you my friend. Amen. To God be the glory. My frenemies, I thank you.
Amen.
I'm praying for you anyhow. To God be the glory. Let's stand as we go to the word. Amen. We are going to the book of Matthew.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We're going to chapter 28, beginning at verse 16. Again, that's Matthew 28, verse 16. Amen. And as you turn in, if you'll allow me to pray, Father God, I just thank you, oh Lord. Thanking you, God, for the opportunity to stand before your desk, oh God. I'm asking you to hide me behind your cross. Speak to me, God, and through me. Open my ears and my eyes to see what you would have me to see, oh God, and put the enemy on mute, oh God, so that I can speak what you say, oh Lord, and not what Maria, Dream Maria Wright says, but what you say, oh God. I thank you, Lord. I thank you and I honor you on this day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Matthew 28, beginning at verse 16. I am coming to you from the New King James Version. And it reads as thus. Then the 11 disciples went away into Galilee to the mountain which Jesus had appointed for them. Just saw that. To the mountain which Jesus had appointed for them. When they saw him, they worshiped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, all authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. Amen. May the Lord add a blessing to his already blessed word. You may be seated. Amen. In the presence of the Lord. And we just talked about that. Minister Dolores said, I will be with you. God said, I will be with you always. You know, as I was studying and preparing for the day, today the Lord took me back to a sermon that Reverend James Hardy of Greater Light Missionary Baptist Church shared when he delivered the word back in March 2017 here at St. Judah. And the thing for which he spoke was he was saying, holding on to heaven while hell is on my back. And he spoke from Matthew 28, 16 to 20, this very familiar passage regarding the great commission for which God is commanding us to do. And so like I said, I'm studying, I'm thinking, I'm praying, I'm seeking, I'm searching, I'm asking God, what would you have me to say? Because it's not about what I want to say, because what I want to say don't matter. But God, what would you have me to say? And I thought, you know, if the truth be told, many of us, we more than likely felt that way at some point, if not often during 2020. And we were holding on to heaven while hell was on our back. And because for many of 2020 was a very challenging at best. To some, it was hell on wheels. At times, we were holding on by a thread. But the blessing and the beauty of it all is that we did not let go. We may have wheeled, we may have wobbled, but to God be the glory, we didn't fall down.
And we didn't break, and we continued to hold on, realizing that if we were going to make it, it was solely going to be with the help of the Lord. So when I was studying, I thought, Lord, what's going on for real? Because that's how we talk, you know. What's going on for real? And thus, the thing for today's message was birthed, and it is, we made it. We're still here. Now what? Yeah. After all, if we just look back on this last year, for some this last week, maybe even some this morning, we truly owe God a hallelujah praise because we survived. We made it through the pandemic thus far. No plague has come nigh our dwelling. We made it through the loss of loved ones. We made it through health issues, financial issues, mental issues, car issues, assassination of our character, lies, manipulation, and deception. We made it through family issues, relationship issues, employment issues, issues with church folks, work folks, and just folk in life in general. But we made it. We survived, and we're still here to give God thanks. Yes. To express our gratitude, to worship Him.
Yes.
Because He is the one who brought us through. We survived to give the testimony of our test. My question is, now that you've made it and God brought you through, what are you going to do next?
Jesus.
Are you going to sit on your rusty dusty and let insecurity, corruption, and lawlessness, or in other words, disobedience of what's going on in the world today and those around you, prevent you from doing what God has called you to do, prevent you from walking in your purpose? Or are you going to go out and minister to the masses about the goodness of the Lord so that they can experience the love of Christ through you? Are you going to ask God to shed light on the darkness in your life so that you can see? Are you going to stand on the rock that has kept you all year long? Or are you going to waddle in doubt and self-pity about what you think may happen to you or what you don't have or are limited to or with, or while chalking it up to the guise of this is what can't be done because of the pandemic or because of what the mayor, the governor, the president is telling us we must do? My question to you, are they more powerful than the God you serve? Can they provide the same insight that God can? Can they reveal to you that which you must do? Do you understand that there is a grace on your life to release the glory of God? Are you going to fail in the role to fulfill the mandate of the Great Commission? Back to our text. Help me, Holy Ghost. Hold me. We're coming in at the very end of Matthew, and we're in this book. We travel through the birth, death, burial, and resurrection of Christ. We see throughout the book of Matthew how the Holy Spirit moved in and through the work and the life of Jesus, and while he was here on earth and even after his death. A work that consisted of teaching, proclaiming the gospel, and the healing of every kind of disease and sickness. Jesus never acted on his own, but he was guided by what the Father told and showed him. He was full of the Holy Spirit, led by the Spirit, and he ministered by the Spirit. And if we're paying attention or have paid attention to what we find when we're reading his word, we should have or we will realize that in order for us to complete any assignment that God has given to us, we have to follow the leading teaching and guidance of the Holy Spirit. This is not a journey that we can do on our own. We cannot do it without him or only by calling on him when we need him. Jesus is not a genie in a bottle that's here to grant your every wish. He is not someone you can pimp to meet a temporary need or fix. No. He's so much more than that, and he has so much for you than temporary satisfaction and gratification. There is not a drug, an ounce of alcohol, or any amount of money, or the finesse of a good lover that can exceed or excel the love that Christ has for you, the love that he has for us. Fast forward into chapter 28. We find that Jesus has risen, was seen by Mary Magdalene and the other Mary. Some say it's the Mary mother of Jesus, but it's not. It's the other Mary and the disciples. He was revealing that the scripture had been fulfilled after 3 days, which said he would rise again. However, not everybody was happy that he had risen, nor did they want the truth of what he has spoken to be revealed to the masses. You see, the chief priests didn't want the truth to get out because it would reveal the wrong that they have done and said. And even unto this day, amongst some of the Jews, That lie is still spoken and is floating around. It's still perpetuated. However, to so many more people across the world today of different races, creed, and color, greater revelation has spread of his rising. The truth got out anyway.
Yeah.
So how many of you, no matter what people say against you and the work that you do to the glory and honor of God, God will vindicate you. The truth will get out anyway. For as long as you're doing what he has called you to do, he said, I will be with you always, even until the end of the age. One thing about the truth is you have a choice to believe it or not. However, denying it, ignoring it, or trying to explain it away is not going to change the fact that it's the truth.
Yeah, God.
Our
yeah,
truth
God.
Is that Jesus died and he rose and he is now seated on the right hand of the Father. Jesus, through his rising, spoke to the disciples and is also telling us that not only does all authority rest with him as given by the Father, but that he was given his disciples and us the authority to conduct a similar ministry of preaching, teaching, and deliverance in his name.
Uh-huh.
Again, I'll say it again, in his name. In his authority. We conduct ministry in his authority. So when we move in Jesus' authority, it activates God's power. But without his authority, that which you do will fall on deaf ears and won't accomplish a thing. Jesus' plan was for us, the spirit-filled believer, to go into the world and continue his ministry with the confidence that he will be with us until the end. So you say, because I hear you, out there, you say, and how am I supposed to do that? I don't even know where to begin. Well, I'm so glad you asked. Amen. Because first of all, you start by spending time in his presence. You can't do anything until he gives you direction. Read and study your Bible. Don't read it for entertainment or to check off a mark showing completion for your daily to-do list. But study and show yourself approved unto God so that you may be able to rightly divide his word. Spend time in praise and worship. Let the presence of the Lord saturate you through the melody and lyrics of his songs. Pay attention to what you are singing. Do the lyrics line up with the word of God? Remember that out of the heart the mouth speaks. What you allow to saturate in your spirit and in your heart will be revealed when you open your mouth. Number two, listen, sometimes you just need to shut up and stop telling God what you want or what you think and just listen to what he wants you to do, for his ways are not our ways and his thoughts are not our thoughts. And I hate to break it to you, Angel, but he actually knows far better than you do and far more than you do. Number three, pray. Oftentimes, especially during difficult situations, results and answers don't come by what you say, but by what you pray and how you pray. Are you praying amiss or are you praying with the confidence that God will do and accomplish what is best for you in your situation? Are you fasting while praying? For some things only come by fasting and praying. Matthew 7:24-25 says, anyone who listens to my teaching and follows it is wise, like a person who builds a house on a solid rock. Yes. Though the rain comes and the torrents and the flood waters rise and the winds beat against that house, it won't collapse because it's built on a bedrock. Amen. In other words, you are on solid foundation. You are on a firm foundation. And it's no secret that during 2020, the storms of life came. Amen. Bringing with them rising waters that tested our reserve. And the winds were so strong that we weren't quite sure if we were going to make it. 2020 was a manifestation of the separation process of the wheat from the tares that God started 3 years ago. Some of y'all may have missed it, but the process started 3 years ago. So 2020 has revealed to those who actually trust him versus those who say the right words, who are well-versed at speaking the religious language while their actions portray the exact opposite. I'm confident that even on today, as we round out the end of 2020, that someone under the sound of my voice is still feeling this way. However, please rest assured that no matter what we're going through or have gone through, we are being held in the palm of God's hand, so that no matter which way we turn, he is there. And because he's there, victory is yours for the taking. Jesus intercedes for us in prayer. And God wars on our behalf. Pray and ask God to blow upon you the wind of change from an open heaven so that victory will manifest in your life. Uh-huh. Because victory is produced under an open heaven, because every dark spiritual force that was put in place to trap you has got to flee.
That's right.
Light and darkness cannot reside in the same place at the same time. So as you round out 2020 and prepare to cross over into 2021, seek the Lord and what he will have you to do next with the testimony or the baby that he's birthing in your belly. Birth the spiritual baby first, and the natural baby will come. Your procrastination is causing your delay. God is not denying you. So get in position. Rest on the promises of God. He can't take hold of something until you let it go. For a purpose is destined to come forth, and he needs his warriors for this next move that is emerging. There is too much work to be done in a short period of time, and so the enemy knows it and is on a rampage to tear down God's warriors. But stay prayed up and stay girded up. Clothed in the whole armor of God. Stay tuned and to his channel via the Holy Spirit, so that you can shift when he shifts. In other words, when he move, you move just like this. So if he go to the right, you to the right. If he goes to the left, to the left. If he stand still, if he back that up, y'all hear me, y'all feel me. Yeah. Be able to shift with the shift of the Lord.
Yeah.
For we made it.
Yes.
And we're still here.
Yes.
So Lord,
thank you.
Let's ask him.
Yes, Lord.
Let us ask him now. What would you have me to do? To God be the glory.
Amen.
On behalf of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, amen, to anyone and everyone who's listening who has not made a choice to receive Jesus as their personal Savior. I want you to know that God loves us with an awesome and genuine love that we cannot even explain. And God's will for every one of our lives is that we would be saved. His will is that none would perish, but all would have eternal life. But the thing about it is, God does not force himself on anyone. We have to make that decision for ourselves. So the Lord said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. And if any man hear my voice and open up the door, he said, I will, not I might. But I will come in and sup with him and he with me. He also cautions us. He says, the day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. But he said, all those who come unto me, I will in no wise cast you out. So God is speaking to someone today and letting you know that God knows you best. Faults, strengths, weaknesses. He knows everything about you. Nothing's hid from him, but yet he loves you so much. You have a soul that is so precious to God. And he wants to be a part of your life. Not just the part, but the center. And he said, no matter what you're going through, no matter what you've done, if you would receive him, he will change your whole life. And even you, something beautiful can come out of your life. Is there one today that's saying, you know what, Lord? I'm not going to fight you anymore. I'm going to give you my life. And the Lord says this, if you would confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, and if you would believe in your heart, you shall be saved. Make that confession today, and salvation is yours. Amen. Perhaps there's someone who knows the Word of God, and you decided that you wanted to enjoy the pleasure of this life, and you found that that separated you from the God you know and the God you love. But at this time, you're saying, Lord, I'm so sorry. And everything that's out there can't do me like you do me. Doesn't love me like you love me. It was a deception. It was a trick of the enemy. And now, God, I want to come back to you. I want to go return to you, God. Will you receive me? I can tell you 100% that Jesus' answer is yes. He said, I've never stopped loving you. I've never given up on you. I was just waiting for you to come back to me. So if that is you today, know that you are a son and daughter of the Most High. And perhaps you're looking for a church home, some place where you can unite with some people, amen, that will love on you, amen, that'll help you grow and nurture you. Because Jesus said, come just like you are. You don't got to know it all. You don't got to know anything but Jesus. And if you accept him, from that point on, God said, I got you. And you're looking for a place where you can grow, learn, see the beautiful gift that God has placed in you and use it for his glory. If the Spirit of the Lord is saying this is the body of Christ that he wants you to be affiliated with, know that our love extends to you. And we are more than happy to receive you as a brother or sister in Christ right here at St. Judas Spiritual Baptist Church. And if you don't know where that place is, it is 43 Anacostia Road, Northeast Washington, D.C., 20019. You have a home here, should you choose it. God bless you. We have done as God has commanded us. We have given you the invitation for salvation, the invitation for reconciliation, and also the invitation for affiliation. Please take God up on his offer. Amen. Amen.
Yes, here is the powerful preaching. Hallelujah. Yes, here is the invitation. And the Lord had put upon my heart to ask and plead to the ones, you know where you stand with him.
Amen.
You don't want to go into another year the same way you are now.
Amen.
It's no time or plan, because this time the pandemic hit, we don't know what's coming next.
Right. Yeah.
So you better get right with God.
Hallelujah.
And do it now. He's still standing.
Yes.
With his outstretched arms.
Amen.
Telling you to come. You think you're having fun. But come on to Jesus. Give him a try.
Yeah.
I guarantee you, you'll never have so much fun.
Amen.
And you don't have to look over your shoulder.
Amen.
We are pleading to you. Give your life to Christ.
Yeah.
Don't wait. Don't worry about what people are going to say. But come and give your life to Christ.
Yeah.
And on my last note, I just want to thank God so much. Amen. If, I don't know if they could take the camera and go around the building, but I just want to thank Brother White. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, he has the church decorated. Amen. There's nobody. He not having services, but the Lord put on his heart still come.
Yes.
And decorate the church, and it looked beautiful.
Amen.
Amen. We thank God for you, Brother Wright, and you know, for God putting it on your heart. And I thank God for the staff. Amen. Because without the staff, we wouldn't have it on the television and live streaming. Amen. And YouTube and all this good technology. So I just want to thank the staff publicly and privately. Amen. Amen. Yeah, we're a marvelous God. And this just one step.
Amen.
There's many more we're going to take.
That's right.
All right. God bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
While we're yet standing, amen, we're looking to God to be dismissed. Amen. Now unto him who's able to keep us from falling and present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore. And let every believer say,
Amen.
This concludes our service for today. Be blessed and be a blessing. And if you should see anyone without a smile, be kind enough to give them one of yours. God bless you.